I'm Tom, and today I'm going to show you how to print flexible filament. Now, this is going to be much less of a classic guide, because the basic process is the same for every kind of filament. You strap it into your extruder, heat up the printer, and then print something out. Instead, I'm going to show you the five most important things to keep in mind to successfully print with flexible filaments. But before we start, what is this flexible filament anyways? The guys from E3D sent me some Ninjaflex, which is a patented filament that's based on thermoplastic polyurethane, or short TPU. It's often also simply called TPE, or thermoplastic elastomer. It's very elastic but isn't really springy, rather it dampens movement a lot but always moves back into its original shape. There are a couple other varieties of flexible filaments, like Filaflex or flexible PLA, and these tips mostly apply to all of them. Tip number one, align your hob bolt and the feed hole of your hot end. When I started printing flexible filament, I could barely get it out any faster than at a snail's pace or it would buckle in the extruder. That was because that tiny misalignment of just about a millimeter between the center of the hobbed area and the feed hole forced the filament into a curved path, which is one of the worst things for printing flexible filament. So spend a little extra time getting your hobbed bolt to line up. Also, you might notice that there is a Teflon tube in my extruder, and that is tip number two. If you have a Bowden compatible hot end, or even if you don't have one, you can use a piece of Bowden tubing to guide the filament all the way from the drive gear or hobbed bolt into the hot end, as that reduces the friction on the filament as it pushes against the sidewalls of the filament channel in the extruder body and hot end. The E3D V6 makes that easy, as all 1.75mm V6s are essentially a Bowden version, and you can use one continuous piece of tubing all the way from the drive gear to the bottom of the heatsink. Tip number 3. The Bowden tube trick works well for 1.75mm, but what about 3mm filament? Well, as it turns out, 3mm filament is way more stable down the extruder hole, so if you have the choice between a 3mm and 1.75mm printer, use the 3mm one for the flexible materials. Also, long Bowden tubes can be tricky. Tip number 4. A heated bed isn't necessary, but it helps. My new favorite thing in 3D printing is regular household glue stick, which is absolutely awesome because it grabs onto your prints as long as they are warm, but completely lets go once everything is cooled off. So for Ninjaflex, set your heated bed to about 40 degrees Celsius and use a thin layer of glue stick as your bed topping. Tip number 5. If everything else fails, print slow. This is especially true when you know that your printer works well with PLA or ABS, but you just can't seem to get the flexible stuff printing reliably. Remember, this is a completely different class of raw material, so you might need to use completely different settings. Generally, 40mm a second is already a pretty high speed for the flexible stuff, but you might need to drop that as low as 5mm a second to get it printing properly. There's no shame in doing so if it gets your printed part out. Bonus tip, because apparently I can count to 5, calibrating your extruder the classic way with flexible filament isn't going to be much use, so use your tried and true settings from your ABS or PLA profile and fine tweak the extrusion multiplier as you go. So, that's the most important things to keep in mind when you're trying flexible filament. As far as the other settings go, it's all cooking by the book. Extruder temperature around 215 degrees Celsius, and bridges and overhangs might be a bit harder to print. So, there you have it. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, and share this or any of my other videos, and check out the survey in the video's description to influence which topics I cover next.